things through Christ.
You know, this is Apostle Paul, right? He said, I can do all things through Christ.
Which strengthened me.
Confidence. I have confidence in Christ. Why? Because Christ gives me the strength to face everything. He the one that gave me the strength to face everything. He the one that bring me out of everything that I get into. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Believe me, you know, young brothers and sisters, I've been in some everything. If it is a God to get somebody out of something, God have gotten me out of it. Yeah. I did some things, baby, I sure didn't went to jail for. But I got away with it. Mm-hmm. No matter how did you get away, I walked away. That's what I did. You know, intuition sometimes makes you know you better get out of here. So I walked away. I ain't robbed no bank. I ain't killed nobody. You know, I just did some more deadly things that you can do. Something, like we said, something lead up to sin.
Yes.
Something lead up to you going to jail. They're going to hunt you down. But, you know, the little thing we did, you know, you could walk away. You know, soon as we got through done, we done. Said, let's go, man.
Right now.
So we left out. And I could have went to jail for it. I thought about it after I sobered up. Come to yourself. So I got away from it. But those were the days I did not know God. Church people just don't act like folk that are in the world. Mm-hmm. Church people ain't got no business. You a church person? He said, well, I belong to Mount Calvary Baptist Church. If you belong to the Baptist Church, you still ain't got no business going out to sin because other folks, right, they're going to put you on the same level as any other church. If you go to church, you're not supposed to be getting into stuff. Now, you can go to jail before you go and join the church. Folks won't just say, well, old Tom went to jail. That's all. Then the next thing you know, old Tom is out of jail. He said, he out now, man. Then he's going to say, he been out how many years? Say, he been out a long time. And they're going to say that with, and, you know, with the emphasis up on it. He's been out a long time now. And that sound good to them. But the time you spend in there, it affects you. But the Apostle Paul is letting us know. The reason why I can do it because Christ gave me the strength to face everything. Mm-hmm. It's good to have Christ in your life. It's good to have received the Holy Ghost. This is how this is how we're gonna get out of things, and the reason we need him, and you know, and we need to have confidence in him. I don't care how much confidence you have in me, some things I can't help you with. Mm-hmm. You know, I don't have the power that Christ has. Well, you come to me, I can fall on my knees and pray. Yeah. I believe that God will hear my prayer.
Yeah, Lord.
But power, God have power unseen. God know how to change things.
Amen.
And he can do just that.
Amen.
He can change things. I can do all things through Christ who strengthened me. Give me the power to do it. And I thank God that I found out about it. I found out that there is a power.
Yeah, Lord.
When I wanted to stop doing things and couldn't do it, I wanted to stop. I didn't want to be out on the street Friday night. I had some unusual sense. Sometimes when I would be in such bad shape, my friends, they want to ride. I said, no, y'all can't ride with me tonight, man. I said, if anybody was going out, I was going out by myself. Let none of you all go with me. I said, you can't ride with me. I would ride by myself. So point there where I knew something had to be done, and I thank God that God came in just in time. In November 1970, God came just in time. Yeah. He saved me from that. When God saved me from it, I disliked it so much that I ain't never want to go back to it no more. Club ain't there no more. I'ma call the name. Mm-hmm. Y'all know it. Shepherd Lounge. Right. Y'all went up there.
Yes.
I went up there to Shepherd Lounge. And there's a lot happened there. And I thank God. God brought me out.
Thank you, Lord.
Yeah, the one was closed up in, right up in. And I didn't know anything about the club name, but my friends, you know, that went to certain other places, showed me all those places. I had been in there for 4 years, and they were showing me things. God can bring you out, though.
Yes, he can.
If you trust in him, God can deliver you. I don't care how bad a condition you're in. He is a deliverer.
Yes, he is.
He is a deliverer. Amen. And like I said, we as saints of God love everybody.
Yeah.
I heard you preaching about this. I heard you preaching about that. But I love everybody.
Right.
I know how to differentiate between them and the sin that they are committing.
Yeah.
Love everybody. Sound like you don't love them. One of my cousins the other week, he said, somebody said, I hear somebody talking about you, Bishop Kennedy, talking about you hard on this, hard on that. He said, yeah, you just as hard as the other men.
All right.
I said, but I love everybody. I love everybody because I know what sin, how many know what sin is going to do for you?
Yeah, Lord.
Sin was going to cause you to go to a place that you'll never get out of. If you go there, I don't care what you do, one won't be able to help you. That's why we better try to help as much as we can. I have confidence in the Lord Jesus Christ. I believe he can do anything but fail. Mm-hmm. Hebrews 13:6 said, so that we may boldly say, the Lord is my helper.
And I will not fear what man
should do. I'm going to know that God is your helper.
Yeah, Lord.
God can help you in anything that you need. You can be getting ready to be locked up.
Yes.
I believe one time they were ready to lock me up. Mm-hmm. And I didn't know God enough to cry out to him. All I could do is just bank on him. Mm-hmm. When you're in the armed service, you weren't allowed to fight. So I think they were getting ready. But everybody treated me nice, even the person I had to fight with. Mm-hmm. Isn't that strange? Spoke good things about me, the person I had to fight with.
Mm-hmm.
Spoke good things. And he got it where he ended up. You can't say, well, he did that because he beat you. No. Uh-uh. He got the where he ended up. But he spoke well of me. That left with him, they sent me right on home. But God is good. And those kind of things you don't rejoice in. That's why I was thinking today, when I think on that too, I was thinking on how I should have had a Bible back then. Mm-hmm. When I'm doing go crazy stuff like that, mm-hmm. I should have had a Bible. Some people say, well, one time, well, okay. But I still, when I look back, I should have had a Bible. I should have been in church, mm-hmm. in Sunday school, somewhere. You know, I should have been in the Air Force. I should have been working with the chaplain. Mm-hmm. That's where I should have been. ain't had no business being nowhere else. Mm-mm. I should have been at the chapel on Sunday. It wasn't nothing but bringing the books, doing something, nothing but sweeping up in there. That's why I should have been. I haven't been ever being out in the world. Mm-mm. When I look back, you look back on your life.
Yes.
When you want to be back out of there, Bishop Finley used to tell us that we all had to go up through here. I sure wish I hadn't. I wish I had been in God's hand, totally in his hand. I was in his hand, but totally in his hand. Serving him, things would have been much better for me. Because folks had a tendency to like me anyway, you know, regardless of what color they were. You know, even those people who were Mexican, they liked me. Me and Aunt Jose, good. They were Spanish folk, but they liked it. And I wished I could have given them the love that they, you know, were giving me. I'm talking about real men. Me and another man, we was in charge of quarters at night. He was a Caucasian. He and I worked all night together. He would call me, he said, Curtis, he said, this weekend, I'm going to take you out to dinner. I said, where are we going? He knew I like to eat. He said, we're going to a Chinese place. One of the best places I ever went to. And when I was in Amarillo, Texas, he took me there, paid for everything. If you carry yourself, that good qualities about people that is not in the church. I wasn't in the church, but there were good qualities. I had good qualities. I was a good athlete. I know how to treat people ordinarily. You know, but when you get messed up in that mess out there, you a mess then. Ain't that right? So we have to thank God. Thank God. But I thank God now. I have total confidence in the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I don't trust the enemy. I don't trust the devil. Not talking about individuals. I don't trust the devil. The devil bring you something. He tell you to do this, you better do the opposite. He tell you to do good, you better go on somewhere else and do it. Don't hang and tell you to do bad. But you better go on somewhere else and leave that alone, because it's a trick up with him. Amen?
Amen.
It's a trick up with him. Have confidence in the Lord Jesus Christ and him. Philippians 1:6 tell us, you know, Philippians 1:6 said, being confident
of this very
of this
thing,
very thing,
that he which hath begun a good work in you.
Listen, that he which hath begun, begin to do a good work. Right. I mean, know sometimes God is working on you.
Yeah.
I remember when I got out of Susan in 1969, the Lord was working on me. Every Sunday I would go to church. Yeah. I would go with my mother and father, but I wait till they went to Sunday school because I didn't want to go to Sunday school. They would go on. Sometimes I would take them to Sunday school because I had a car and they didn't. I'd take, you know, Bishop Kimbrell, my brother, he was young, and Deacon Kimbrell, my mother. My daddy would be on the boat. So I would take them to church. I take them, I come back home, I may be in the bed or what have you. But, you know, at that time, I should have been in church too. Back in those days, you know, I was getting into things. I was learning the streets. Didn't know, as much as I've been in the streets, I didn't know the streets of Mobile. Amen. But God will deliver you. He will deliver you if you keep your mind somewhat on him, think on him, and pray. Every now and then I go, didn't know how to pray, but I come to church, I kneel down on the altar, just like everybody else. Mm-hmm. Wouldn't look at nobody, I was sincere. There's sinners that is sincere. When I think about how I was what, sincere, and the Lord will deliver you. Philippians said what now?
Being confident.
Being confident of this very thing.
That he which hath begun a good work in you.
But he that which hath begun to do a good work in you.
Will perform it unto the day of Jesus Christ.
God will finish the work.
Yes, he will.
How many know that God is working on you?
Yeah.
I knew that God was working on me. Mm-hmm. I would go to work. I couldn't have no peace. Mm. All day long. The only time I had peace was when I was working. Mm-hmm. On them breaks. If I sat there, you know, and then talked to somebody, no peace. Because there was time for me to come out of that. There come a day and time when you need to come out. And you need to turn your attention totally to the Lord. Nobody else but the Lord. That was the only time I would have peace. When my mind was on him.
Right.
But when I wasn't at work, Friday night, Saturday night, if my head was halfway right, your friend be begging for you. And that's all you have at that time, is your friends. How many know what I'm talking about?
Mm-hmm.
I didn't have no church friends because I wasn't a church
right.
person.
Right.
I wish I'd have had some church friends. You know, I'm talking about ones in the A.O.H church.
Right.
I didn't have none. I didn't have a church friend to my knowledge in the A.O.H church. Not a one. So when my friend did this, give me a minute. I'll be down in the car.
Mm-hmm.
And that it's not that that individual is really interested in what they're doing. A lot of times, you know, folk doing things, they're not really interested. Their mind ain't really into it. They feel like they don't have nothing else to do. These are my friends. These are the only friends I have. This is what we know to do. And that's what they do. But I'm glad that God pulled me out. During that time, I could have lost my life. I could have lost my life. I really could have because of incidents, things that happened. Before then, I could have lost my life when I was off in those other places. But because of God, God did. Somebody said, well, who kept it? God did.
Yeah, Lord.
It wasn't the enemy. That's why you, the enemy ain't going to do no good. Eh? The enemy, he was on their side. One that had the gun that was probably shooting at you. One that tried to stab you with a knife. That was the enemy. That was his partner.
Mm-hmm.
And God was the one that pulled him back.
Right.
God sent that person.
Oh, yeah.
Pulled the other one back. If it had not been for God. Yeah. Sometimes some of this stuff happened in high school. If it hadn't, and you know this unusual. There was a young man wanted to fight. Every time he seen me, he wanted to fight. And really, head up, he couldn't do nothing with me.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing to brag about.
Mm-hmm.
But yet, he just couldn't stand it.
Mm-hmm.
Because he and I had a run-in when they were building everything in the court. And every time he seen me, same thing. But he had really beat me. Stick. That's the way. This is the way the devil works. You got to be careful. You got, and nobody know how to handle the devil. And when he did, I timed him. Young men know what I'm talking about. When he went back, I rushed in and flipped him. When I flipped him, I heard him then. And his partner pulled me up all over. Is that a hurting feeling? Back then, that's a hurting feeling. Because he had beat me with a stick until my eyes and things puffed up and everything. These are the things that young folk get into. And young people these days, what y'all call them, XYZ? They call them XYZ. But millennium, all hooked up in that folks. They got another attitude. They would take you out. They would take you out. So when he did that, then, and his partner pulled me up off of him, he came out with a knife. I thought about that today. I seen myself cut. I seen myself stabbed. I could have lost my life right there in New York. That's why when I look back, as I should have been in church, I needed a Bible. I needed a Bible. I'm going to know a lot of the young folk now, that's what they need in the Bible.
Yes.
They need to be in church. They need to be doing some things in God's church.
Yes.
I'm not talking about playing, but I'm talking about sincere.
Yes.
They're sincere in what they're doing. And they can read Philippians 4 and 13. I can do all things. And you can do anything you want to do. You can go to college, get a good, get a good education. You can get you a good job. Yeah. Then you can go out and work with some of your friends. Yeah, you can do all things. And you'll be able to go through a lot of things too, with the help of God.
Amen.
Sin that you don't have to commit. Yeah. I heard someone was talking about someone had what called HIV. That's because what they was out there in this type of environment, in the church.
Yes.
Church gonna teach you against things like that.
Yes.
To what? Prolong your life. Church gonna talk against other things. When you hear the church talking about, homosexuality, it's not just that. It's sometimes it's the diseases that they catch while they're out there. Sometimes they preach against things like that, but they never bring out the total big picture.
All right.
There's so many diseases that you can catch.
Amen.
So many diseases you can catch, out going with, different individuals, a whole lot of folks, men and women, heterosexual and homosexual and all this, you're going with all of them. I can see what God is talking about. I mean, you see what you're talking about. I can see what you're talking about. You're going to catch diseases because they are doing some everything and multiple partners. That's why God tell one to have your own wife, have your own husband. And that's it. That's where it ought to be. Amen. That is the reason God don't give you the whole essence of everything. He don't put it all together. We now you have to put it together and show you what he's really talking about. Mm-hmm. Then those things, when you see the big picture, then you see, I see what God talking about. Because I had a friend to die from things like that and so forth and so on. Amen?
Amen.
So thank the God. Thank the Lord. Don't ever think that, because they preach and teach against that, they love. Done out of love. Amen.
Amen.
And hoping that you come out. Romans 8:37, I'm almost through. My time almost up to. 8:37.
Nay.
It's a nay in all anything.
We are more than conquerors.
The Bible says we are more than conquerors.
Through him that loved us.
Through him that loved us. With the Lord Jesus, we can conquer.
Amen.
We can conquer sin. We can overcome sin. We can make it through the day without going to jail, without robbing a bank, robbing an individual, getting into stuff. Mm-hmm. Thank God. I was a young man, didn't have, the training that I should have had. Had a lot of good training, but I ain't had no street training. I didn't train. I didn't know how to do like the other fellas. So when they said, come on, let's go and do that, all right now. Could lead in that. I could lead in other things. In sports, and I was one of the best leaders. But when it came to things in the world, I didn't know nothing about it. I was introduced to these things by, young men from up north, young men from Chicago and New Jersey. places like that.
Yeah.
New York. I got to run with them thugs, you know. He thought they were cool. He took something to run with them. And they would do some of anything. Thank God that the Lord didn't allow me to go as far as they did. I never wanted to really smoke marijuana. That's strange. I was around men that did that. Yeah. Marijuana. That's what they did. They, you know, one smoking so much he would go to sleep. And I make a decision, I said, well, since he's sleeping, we're gonna leave him. Not to let go. We leave him right there. You ain't be careful, you come back the next morning. Find him right there. I never understand why he slept so much. One did and he kept going. The other one went to sleep. Yeah, so but you have to thank God that God is a deliverer. God is a conqueror in you. And all these things, yeah, will more than conquer through him that loves us. With the Lord Jesus, you can conquer some things.
Yeah,
Lord Jesus, you can make it. Lord Jesus, you can go, you know, God can bring you out. Bring this a good message to sinners. God can bring you out because he brought me out.
Yeah, Lord.
I know he can bring you out.
Yes, he can.
Amen. He's that kind of God. Hallelujah. And these folk today that's on the street, they sure enough need God.
Amen.
And their life. They need the Lord Jesus Christ like never before. I was listening at the news, seemed like it's another child. It sounded like it's about three of them got shot.
Jesus.
You know, three children, you know, innocent kids got shot. Couldn't, and all three. One did lose their life. I think the girl was 15 years old, lost her life. So the other young kids could have lost their life. I thought about it, I would have hated to die at an early age. I would have hated for that boy to stab me with that knife and kill me. Because I wouldn't have got a chance to do some of the things I did, places I seen. You know, life is beautiful.
Yes.
You know, you may not be saved, but God have given you life.
Yeah, Lord.
For you to enjoy life. Sure, we want you to be saved because we know that you're missing out on the best when one is saved. But it's still some good things.
Yes.
Some wonderful things to see in this world. I never will forget, we was in Hawaii, and we kept taking a trip on the boat. Went down between some mountains in the Pacific, you know, where the mountain was just on one side. It looked like the mountain just came up out the water, and we passed by. And here come a man. I wonder today where he came from, in a canoe. He was roaring in the canoe. Then when we got on round a little bit further, there was others, you know, in small boats way out there in the Pacific, you know. Things is out there, especially those of us who are from Alabama. There's a lot of things we miss, we don't see that is out there. Things up north, you go up north and see high risers. My brother told me, he deceased now, Whitty told me, he said, when you come to Chicago, he said, make sure you don't be looking up.
All right.
He said, call them thugs. He said, they gonna know that you ain't been. So he said, hey, no. It's a lot of things right here in America that is wonderful to see. There's a lot of things that men that do different things, men that hunt. You know, they go out and kill a rabbit, they act like they got $1 million. Things they enjoy. They enjoy things like that. Farmers. They said, man, come over here. watermelon I just made. This is one of the biggest watermelons I ever grown, man. They get some joy out of that. Then sometimes you, as an individual, will be happy with that person.
Yeah.
Is that right? So many things to see. So many things to learn in this world. But one to throw their life away, go out and lose your life at an early age. I reckon pretty hard on that because one of my sisters, she lost her life. She was 35 years old. And that's a hurting thing. A hurting thing for that to happen. Mm-hmm. And for as we were concerned, she was a good girl. A good girl. But the enemy don't care nothing about you out there. Your life is much better. You can live a better life in the church than you can out in the world. Somebody said, well, church so boring. Y'all do the same thing over and over. I wish I could have did the same thing over and over when I was in the Air Force. And never had gotten in trouble. Could have made more money out of him. When you get in trouble, they're gonna punish you for getting in trouble. Is that right? Mm-hmm. There is punishment for you everywhere you go. Amen. God is a good God. He's worthy to be praised. I can do all things through Christ, which strengthens me, who give me my strength. I can do it. I can make it. With him, I can make it. Without him, now I look back on see how I made it without him. So some say he was there all the time.
Yeah.
Amen. One or two more scriptures, then we're going to stop. Zechariah 4 and 6. Amen.
Then he answered and spake unto me,
saying,
this is the word of the Lord unto Zerubbabel.
This is the word of the Lord unto Zerubbabel.
Saying,
not by might, nor by power,
but by my spirit, said the Lord of hosts.
That's the way it's done. You can do it by the spirit of the Lord. Yeah, you can make it with the spirit of the Lord. But without the Holy Ghost, it's going to be all virtue that impossible for you to do a lifetime. Good things without the Holy Ghost. That's why in the Holy Church we put emphasis on one receiving the gift of the Holy Ghost. It is a gift. And the gift, all what one has to do is what? Come out, reach your hand out, either they put it in it or you grab hold to the gift that they're giving to you. It is a gift. All you got to do is grab hold to it. All you got to do is receive. It's something that, you know, really you can't pay for it. Because Jesus, he paid it all.
Amen.
When he went to the cross, he died for you. It must be something good. If he died for you to receive this, to live a better life, it has to be something good. And I wouldn't dare leave here unless I got a taste. I guarantee you, if you ever get a taste of the real Holy Ghost, you won't want nothing else. You'll tell everything else goodbye. You'll tell everything else you don't want it no more. $1 million won't be as good as the Holy Ghost. But if you receive the Spirit of God, the Bible tells us that the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof the world. As well, that everything in the world belongs to the Lord Jesus Christ. And then the Bible tells us that we are heirs of his and joint heirs, whatever he owns. And you're going to get a part of them. You're going to get a part of them. And if I may say, when I worked for the gas company, I was thinking I had a chance to become a millionaire.